The rain only increases as we head throughout the afternoon and into the evening, and especially as we get into tomorrow as Hurricane Delta begins to close in on the Texas-Louisiana coast, mainly more towards Louisiana. But it will be close enough now that they have issued a hurricane warning for Jefferson County in far east Texas. So just a heads up on that. Here are some of the feeder bands continuing to rotate on in around Delta. You can see some heavier rain out there towards Cameron, Louisiana, and maybe pushing out towards Winnie and Beaumont here in the next 15 minutes or so, and a few scattered showers here in the Houston area. Those showers push all the way inland towards Shreveport, and you can see they're a little bit of what we call a moat where not a whole lot goes on. You have these rain bands and then it's relatively dry for a little while, and then you have another rain band. So in between rain bands is what we call a moat, and you can see a pretty big one right here. So there will be periodic breaks to the rain, I think, over the next day or so. But as again, Delta closes in on the coast, I think those rain bands are going to get closer and closer together. So a very well-defined system here. In fact, if we take a look at the visible, you'll see there is the eye now beginning to clear out, an indication that Delta continues to strengthen as it pushes towards the southwest Louisiana coast. And by the way, the last time that we saw two hurricanes hit the exact same spot was back in 2004 with Hurricane Francis and Hurricane Jean in southeast Florida, only hitting within 5 miles of the same landfall point. So it looks like we're going to have a very similar situation here in southwest Louisiana. Very unfortunate for those folks, very fortunate for us, as this hurricane will miss us just to the east. You can see how they have expanded that hurricane warning here to include far eastern southeast Texas. Here locally, we are just under that tropical storm warning, and we are still calling for a landfall with a very strong category 2 hurricane, it looks like, with winds of about 105 miles an hour before pushing on up towards the Ohio Valley. So as we take a look at the computer models, you'll see that they are in very good agreement here from Lake Charles out towards Vermilion Bay is about where the landfall point is going to be. And the hurricane hunters continue to fly this, and they're going to fly this continuously over the course of the next 24 to 48 hours as Delta works its way towards the coast. Right now, we're looking at winds just shy of about 100 miles an hour. The official forecast right now, or the official advisory, does show winds of 105. That is just shy of category 3 strength. So as we take a look at where it's going, you've got a big ridge of high pressure here across Florida, an approaching trough of low pressure out across West Texas, and Delta is going to shoot the gap here. So as you see, high pressure will not allow Delta to move any further east, and this trough will not allow it to move much further west. So the only opening here is going to be across southwest Louisiana, but you'll notice the rain breaking out here on the northwest side of the hurricane getting into tomorrow morning. So I think tomorrow we're going to see pretty rainy conditions and breezy across Texas, and of course more high impact wind and rain and surge out across southwest Louisiana. Now once that hurricane pushes off, we're shaping up to be a beautiful weekend. Very heavy rain totals out across Louisiana. Here locally, we may see a half inch of rain, but again, probably not much more than that. Now again, once the storm pushes out on Friday, shaping up to be a beautiful weekend, a cold front coming through on Monday, and that gets us back to where we should be, Sherman, heading into Tuesday.